Daarnaast blijkt uit onderzoek dat antisemitisme en homofoob geweld velen getieren onder Marokkanen. De legitimatie voor deze ellende, de islam.
Verzoekt de regering haar angstige en politiek correcte houding ten aanzien van de islam te laten varen en de negatieve invloed van deze kwaadaardige ideologie die moet worden tegengegaan, verzoekt de regering de islam zoveel mogelijk uit Nederland te bannen en gaat over tot de orde van de dag.
That was me back then. This is me now. I'm no longer a member of the far right. Ironically, the thing that made me join the far right is the same thing that made me leave. It was Islam. And this is my story. My name is Joram van Klaveren and I'm a former member of the Dutch parliament who represented the Party for Freedom, the anti-Islamic nationalist party of Geert Wilders. For years, I gave everything I had to fight against Islam. I tried to make legislation to shut down all Islamic schools in the Netherlands. I attempted to close all mosques, ban the Quran, and ban Islam altogether from the Netherlands. As a Dutch politician, I opposed Islam in every way possible. Then, in 2017, I left parliament and finally had the time to fulfill a long-held desire to write an anti-Islam book. I wanted a book that would provide conclusive theoretical groundings for all of the objections I held against Islam as a politician. My book would settle the dispute about Islam with a clear conclusion. Islam is a danger to Europe, to America, to the West, and actually to the whole wide world. Before writing my book, my view about Islam was influenced by the conservative Protestant environment of my upbringing, in which other religions, and certainly Islam, was definitely seen as wayward and wrong. I was also influenced by the cultural aversion towards Islam that many Europeans have, which was a result of their historic clashes with the Islamic world. And of course, the fears and worries I experienced during years of studying comparative religion at the university formed my opinions. Remarkably, my studies at the university actually began on September 11, 2001. Many horrors would sadly follow, inside and outside of Europe. From the murder of columnist Theo van Gogh, to kidnappings, anti-Semitic terror and beheadings, to haphazard stabs, truck attacks and suicide attacks, to the proclamation of the Caliphate by ISIS. There were even Muslims from the Netherlands who traveled as jihadists to Syria. These events confirmed and deepened my negative feelings about Islam and motivated me to join Wilders' party. I believed that Islam should be fought wherever possible. But as I began writing my book, I came across information that was at odds with the ideas I had. I learned that many of my ideas about Islam, stated by Orientalists, far-right Westerners, and even Islamic extremists, had little or no basis in historical Islam. My research often presented me with context and interpretations that were very different from those I had propagated for years in politics. A more nuanced image of Islam slowly developed in my mind. Seeking more information, I wrote to various academic authorities on Islam, including Professor Abdul Hakim Murad of Cambridge University. He pointed out various scholars, books, and facts, and advised me to read again and more deeply this time. One by one, my objections to Islam vanished. Islam was no longer a religion that promoted violence, hatred, and anti-Semitism, or a religion that categorized women and non-believers as inferior humans and stridently opposed democracy. Slowly, my perspective of Islam was changing. I also received surprisingly satisfying Islamic answers to my existing Christian questions about specific dogmas, such as the Trinity, the sacrifice of Christ, and original sin. All that I was learning about Islam influenced my work on the book in such a way that it began to take on the character of a personal search for God. During this search, the person of Prophet Muhammad raised the most questions with me. Who was this man? A deceiver, an antichrist, or was he truly, as Muslims believe, the last prophet of God? I started to read again about his life, but now without the previous biases I had. And I saw a more than special man, a man with almost supernatural patience, care, love, guidance, and above all, dedication to his God and to his mission for justice. The arguments against his person and against his prophethood disappeared as I made a comparison with Old Testament prophets. In fact, I now understood what the 19th century historian Thomas Carlyle meant when he wrote, "The lies which well-meaning seal has heaped around this man Muhammad are disgraceful to ourselves only." Like all radical ideologies, the far right is toxic too. It presents a reality that strips away all nuance. It answers real problems with lies, and it fights against a religion, Islam, that is not the enemy. The real enemies are a deficit of empathy and ignorance, like the great philosopher Socrates already said. So let us read, study and learn. Extremism is not the answer. My name is Joram van Klaveren for the Emir Stein Center.
This video was produced in collaboration with Alliance of Virtue.